Today we're gonna make this special double exposure effects with the Snapseed app. Watch the full video carefully as you can use similar edits to get these cool results with this free app. I'll be using the effect on this portrait, but first I need to create a black and white image of a toned paper with this image on top of it. I found this image on Unsplash, which is not so suitable, but we are going to make this useful for this edit. First, I'm going to crop this image and make it vertical. Next, gonna convert this to black and white using the black and white tool. I need to remove the text on it. Using curves, dragging the lower left point to the top to make the image completely white. Going to masking screen. Brushing on the text to make it completely white. You can notice still specks of whites and blacks all over the image because of the original grain. Using curves again, I'm gonna add high contrast, which will make the image completely black and white. I will save this. I need to make this narrower as only the eyes will be covered. Using perspective tool and selecting scale option, also choosing black fill. Sliding the finger upwards to scale down, which makes the white part narrower. Repeating the same step once more to make it further small. Now, using double exposure, I'm going to add the saved image and turning it upside down to place the bottom edge, which is a lot straighter at the top. Basically trying to make the top part a bit more straighter. Setting the opacity at 100. Going to masking screen. Brushing it to get this result. We'll make a similar edit to make the bottom part a bit more rough. I'm gonna invert the image. Using curves, turning whites to blacks and vice versa. Saving this as a separate copy. We'll delete this effect as we don't need it now. Now, using double exposure, I'm gonna add this image of a landscape and choose subtract mode. Resizing and placing it so that the horizon is clearly visible. I'm gonna increase saturation and save it. Also, going back to double exposure edit and adding different landscape images and saving these different copies. This we may experiment on the portrait and see how different these look. Now, coming back to the main portrait, resizing it using the crop tool. Adding some blue tones with curves to get more color contrast when we add the overlay images. Also reducing saturation a bit. Now using double exposure, adding first the black tone effect and making sure to place the black areas on the eyes. Choosing darken mode, which reveals only the black areas from the added image. Going to masking screen, removing the excess black areas at the bottom. Now adding the landscape image with lighten mode. There is a bit of manual process to align the added image over the black parts, but it doesn't take much time. It looks good, but there is still something missing to make it look a lot better. That is the shadows. Going back to the last edit before double exposure, here I'm gonna darken the image using curves. Now in the masking screen, adding the darkened effect around the eyes. Tuning further to make the shadow effect better. You can see this insane double exposure effect here. You can also try to make the portrait completely black and white to pop the landscape image more. Also, go back to double exposure and add different landscape images we saved earlier. We don't need to manual align now as they perfectly replace the first image. Some examples which were created with this effect. Hope you all found these tips useful and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.